And the closing dance is Stacy and Carol. good time.
Next, we have our 1990 Mr. Prospector candidates in their personality wear. Thank you.
the respective categories. And I'd like to ask Sarah Probst to help me out with that. The judges will view the performance, then assign a number from 1 to 10 based on a specific criteria for that category. At the end of the formal wear portion, the judges will total their score sheets, and the contestants with 5 high scores will be chosen as our 5 and final. When the contestants are on stage with a personality wear, they will be judged by their creativity and their appropriateness of their outfit to their personality. In the talent competition, the judges will determine the contestant's originality and ability. When the contestants are on stage for the beachwear portion of the show, the judges will determine the proportionality of the chest, bicep, waist measurement, and the boys and candidates display. The judges will see all the candidates. After judging the candidates, appearance, poise, and elegance, we will choose our 5 semifinals. Then the questions will be asked, and finally, we will crown Mr. Prospector 1990. If you'd like to stand up, please. This is Mr. Coonan's last year, and we'd just like to thank him out for his hard work.
Thank you.
keep it down during the people's acts because the judges have to judge them.
Next, we have Everybody's expecting us to dance, right?
Yeah!
You want to see us jam?
I'd like to talk seriously.
seriously just for a moment. One of the greatest art exhibits ever to tour the United States are the treasures of Tutankhamun or King Tut. But I think it's a national disgrace the way we've commercialized it with trinkets and toys, t-shirts and posters. And while about 3 months ago I was up in the woods where I wrote a song, I tried to use the ancient modalities and melodies. I'd like to do it for you right now. But before I do, Rob and I have a very important question to ask two of the lovely ladies in the audience. Beth Logan, will you go to prom with me?
Meg, we go with me.
All right. Now for my song. Hopefully we can all learn something from this. Now when he was a young man, he never thought he'd see people stand in line to see the boy king. How did you get so funky? Now if I had known that they died up just to see him, I'd taken all my money and bought me a museum. Buried with a donkey. He's my favorite donkey. He gave his life for tourism. He's an Egyptian. I'm a nut, don't want no fancy funeral, just one like old King Tut. He could have won a Grammy, buried in his jammies. He's got a condo made of stone.
Yeah. Now, what is this man missing? Well, you start off with, the mind will not work today. The muscle is so good. Oh, look at that lunch. His shirt just looks too normal. We need to lighten it up a little bit and add a little something to it. Put it back in. So much better. And Louis is not his name.
Ah!
my first lovely assistant to bring out the next piece of apparatus. I am going to land in the middle of that hoop and exit the other side. Lovely assistant, the dangerous water trick.
How you doing, Rob?
One last one.
You should come out.
I am.
Okay, Rob, come on out. You come out. Okay, Rob.
Here I am! Hey, here I go. Do you want to do this fresh one?
Dear Rosa and Vera, how do the guys keep up their skin so soft and supple?
Right there.
Well, that has to be, you know, using Dawn instead of soap. I'm just saying, you know,
that is oil the leg.
Yeah, that's what we, you know, we wanted the guys' secrets, and they were a little hesitant to tell us, but it was soft as soap.
Oil the leg.
And aren't we funny?
Thank you. special. She put a live mic backstage to spread the news up on him, so we pray they don't get involved.
Let's all be quiet. And
come on. I got a scuff in my shoes. What should I do?
Hey, come on. Let's go.
Oh, look at that mirror. What's in my eye?
God, man, quick, get that out. Get
it. Here, oh my God.
Let me get it. Let me get it.
Oh, it's on my cheek. Oh, you're killing me. I just got a spot.
Hey, Harris, what do you know about someone else?
Oh,
prudence.
Ah.
have it here.
Thank you.
supposed to come out. I'll call me crazy, but... No, that's it. Wait till I use it.
One of them, right.
A loss for words. God, I'm gonna rake this down.
Alvin Gielen! Yeah! Yeah, okay, so here we go. Rosa, would you like to ask the first question, or shall I?
Oh, okay.
Okay, can you read it? This is for you, Eric Sundquist. If you could change anything about yourself, what would it be and why?
Yeah, I like to hold it.
Just to get you out of your mind off the question.
What was
your most embarrassing moment?
There's no judging on this.
One of my most embarrassing moments was when I finally completed that page. Not really what I wanted.
We all enjoyed it, Eric, didn't we all?
Thank you.
Oh, you kind of talk to, but you're not exactly the best of friends with. Have like a big like piece of paper stuck to their leg, you know, and it was really embarrassing and everyone was making fun of me all day. Would you tell them and lie?
Yeah, I'd tell them. Well, because, I know that when I first came to school, I wasn't that popular with everybody. Now that everyone saw how I dance, it seems like they like me because I can dance. There's some people out there that really don't know me, and I like to get to know everybody. And if that person had something on their leg, I'd take it out. And if anybody tried to mess with me, I'd mess that person up because.
They're not here.
Oh, stand up. Are there any here?
You guys did it!
Rafael Mendoza. The administration for their support of this show. Becky Mandel and Chris Berge.
Is Alvin and
guys next year.
Okay, don't get wet now.
It's raining, it's raining.
Are we going to take any pictures in the house now because it's raining?
Yeah, I'm going. Going without. Wait, you need to get mad in the car.
There for one.
Everyone, let's get ready.
Okay.
This.
busy.
She looks so pretty. Oh, just a second. The door. I want this to be nice. It's pretty. It looks so nice.
Hi.
What smells like stogies?
I don't know. Can't be
here weird. We go, y'all.
Just do a serious. We won't catch this.
Mom, you're not going to see that.
Oh.
You're not going to see it, it's just...
Get over there and get a full-length one. And then that's it. Should I bring my... No, like that?
Well, Dad's going to take it a little bit more.
No,
he can move you around, I guess.
I think I'm going to bring this.
Yeah.
You can bring it.
Okay.
Bring what?
Just don't lose it.
Okay, there's a case up there.
A beer?
The case of...
No, that case of beer.
Now, what are you guys up to? Could you just sort of...
Man, where's the umbrella?
I think Brian has
one. Oh, there it is right there.
Okay. What's going on now?
We're going to the Holodome.
Where's the Holodome?
On Algonquin, don't worry.
We have to be at prom between 6:30 and 7.
And then we're getting a little after.
And then afterwards, we have a little.
Okay, when are you bringing this Corvette back? I guess
tomorrow morning.
Concerned about it. No, where is it going?
To the subway. He's got my car.
Oh, you, but I know. But are you bringing that home tonight?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, but I mean when?
When I get home, Mom.
Watch out for honey.
When I get home, Mom.
All right. Well, just be careful. I'm concerned with the car.
Have a good time.
Driving it, but have a good time. Yes.
Yes.
What time? Where is the limo picking you up?
Anthony.
At Anthony's?
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Brian going with you too?